Change could be coming to some of the businesses in Kansas City's Jazz District.
The city is taking a second look at the rules regarding liquor licenses for bars that are in that area. 41 Action News reporter Andres Gutierrez is there live with a look at what this could mean for that area. Andres.
Rhiannon, and for now, this is simply a recommendation, but many businesses here are calling this a much needed shot in the arm for the future of the Jazz District. For the past year, Smacks has served burgers and a bit of 18th and Vine history. Owner Brandon Dixon also planned to open a daiquiri bar next door, but those plans are on hold after learning he couldn't due to the number of churches in the area.
Once you tell me that there's no liquor, well, you take away the half of the atmosphere. This is a nightlife atmosphere around here. It's the Jazz District. It's the Vine District.
Currently, restaurants and bars in Kansas City, Missouri can't serve liquor within 300 feet of a church or school.
You know, a church, even though they may not, you know, whether it be the managing authority, may not have a real issue with a particular liquor license business going near them, they can't sign off on that because that kind of goes against everything they're saying to say, yeah, we have no issues with liquor being located next to us. And so that presents a problem sometimes.
However, on Monday, the city's alcoholic beverage advisory group recommended lifting the ban within the Jazz District.
That doesn't mean anybody's getting fast-tracked or they're going to get guaranteed a liquor license. It doesn't. It just means those particular things that could kill the process immediately have been waived.
Just imagine there being businesses along that route. From them walking from the museum to eat, they can stop, buy, shop, or drink.
The recommendation comes as the city has pumped more than $25 million to bring in more businesses to the area.
It's lacking economic growth around here, and that's one of the things that's holding us back.
Dixon believes lifting the restriction will give his daiquiri bar a fighting chance.
We want to give Kansas City a good time and another option.
And now this recommendation would have to make its way through City Hall before it becomes law. Reporting live at 18th and Vine, Andres Gutierrez, 41 Action News.